And today what I'm going to do is I'll show you how to take apart a PSP 3000. And this one I bought used for pretty cheap, and the reason being is that it's messed up, and it's mainly the screen. It powers up, but as you'll see, the screen is pretty much it's badly damaged, and the sound does work. And you probably won't be able to see, but you can everything works, the buttons. It's just a screen. It looks like someone probably dropped it or smashed it against something. Probably on this side, as you can see, it's all blacked out. But the also, yeah, that's pretty much it. And it looks like the UMD door. There should be brackets here, I believe. That's not a major concern, because I can what I'm gonna do is replace the full housing, the faceplate and the back plate, with this white casing here. And this one you can find on eBay or other sites. I get this one on eBay, and it was about 20 bucks, and it gives you the full case, the screws and everything, and the buttons as well. And so for this project, what you want to do is to either for the screws, because it's going to be quite a bit of them, is to have little cases like this to stick your screws in, or get a piece of tape, bend it in on itself and just stick it on the table, and then just put the screws on the tape so that they don't fall or roll off the table. And what you'll also need is a screwdriver, a small Phillips head, and a flathead, small flathead. And the next step, what you want to do is you want to unscrew the following screws to take the faceplate out, and it's going to be the one down here by your barcode, and right next to the UMD disk drive, these two, and then the one up here and the one down here. You had to rip out the warranty void sticker to get to this screw right here. And then the screw in here and in here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's 7 screws. And once you take the 7 screws out, you'll be able to get inside to the LCD screen. Now, when you do open this, you want to be careful, and you want to gently open it. That way you don't tear out anything sensitive on the inner components. Okay, and now what you want to do is take this bar right here. And so in order to do that, what you have to do is right here, you want to just stick a flathead screwdriver and stick it in the in between here, and then just prop it out. Okay, and the next part, what you want to do is you want to get this side up and out. So you just want to right here, you'll see, I'm not sure if it'll pick it up, this little notch right there in the gap here. You just want to push that in, and then as you're pushing in, you want to push this part out. Now see, the bar, the whole menu bar is propped up and out. And what you want to do is to take the screen out. And so you just want to right here, right under the white tab, and just stick the flathead under it, and then prop it up until it loosens. And with all this, you want to be, you know, take it slow and take it carefully and be careful. And so now there's this white part here, and see right here, and so you want to prop that up. And so you just take the flathead screwdriver, and then just using this part here as leverage, just pry in like that, and then pop it out. and you don't want to go too deep into here, because there is a part down here. I'm not sure if it's gonna get a good angle. There's a part in here, so you don't want to go too deep. You just want to go enough so that you go under this part here. And then also what you want to do is on this little notch, just stick your flathead screwdriver in between this notch and the LCD screen, and then just kind of pry this notch and push this notch to the left, and then that'll give enough the LCD screen enough room to pop on out. And then you just kind of want to it might be the LCD screen might not want to come out immediately, so what you want to do is you just want to kind of fiddle around with it gently, kind of like pull it up. It should come loose, and then once it does, what you want to do is flip it up and over, and now you have access to the inner parts. And now what you want to do is, let's see, make sure I got this on the screen. You want to take this ribbon cable and this ribbon cable out. And then that'll give you the ability to take the LCD screen and pop it out. Okay, and so now what you want to do is this right here, this little black part, what you want to do is you want to just do a... grab your flathead, and now the reason why you want to use the screwdrivers with the eyeglasses is because all these parts are pretty small. It may not look it on screen, but when you're in person with your PSP, the parts are really, really small. So what you want to do is you want to just put your flathead screwdriver under this black part and lift it up, and it'll release. And at that point, you'll be able to take this ribbon cable out. And then you want to do the same for this big ribbon cable here. Okay, and so now this is how the LCD screen looks as it's detached, and you'll see that it's just attached to the PSP by the big ribbon cable and the small one. And so now what we want to do is to take the home menu bar, and this one, it's only attached by, again, only two ribbon cables. So let me put this back on the tripod, and I'll show you how to take those apart. And what I like to do is, as I'm done with the part, whichever part I'm taking out, I'll put it in a little sandwich bag, so that way it doesn't get any, you know, damage, dust, get any parts lost, like especially for the faceplate, there's still some parts I have to take out later, but for the time being, I'll keep it in the bag here for safekeeping. And so now the next part, let's see. Okay, so for the next part, really, you can go however you want. Before now, I'm going to take the joystick section out. And for this part, what you want to do is to take out the following screws, and it's going to be this one here, and as we move up, this one right here.